name is Terry Moreau. I'm from Shreveport, Louisiana, and I have a bumpy nose. My nose feels bumpy and rubbery. My nose has gotten a little bit bigger on the right side. Sometimes I get boils on the inside of my nose, and they're really painful. I've always had a problem with my complexion since I was very young. My nose started growing about 7 years ago, and as my nose grew, I let my hair grow, kind of cover it up, balance it out. When I lay down and try to fall asleep, I can't breathe because my nose is weighted down over my nostrils. And sometimes I put my arm over my head and hold my nose up with my fingers, and then I fall asleep like that. Sometimes I'll wake up in the middle of the night after I've fallen asleep and I'm not holding my nose up. I'll be gasping for air, and I wake up. It's really frightening. I don't know what the name of my condition is. One time I went to a doctor's appointment, and the doctor noticed my nose and prescribed me a cream for it. And I applied it, and it had no effect on it at all. So I really don't feel comfortable going to the doctor. I like to drink coffee in the mornings before I go to work. And every time I go to take a sip, my nose dips down into the cup. And it's hot, it burns my nose. My nose goes all the way down to the bottom and it gets it wet. My job is a steel fabricator. I'm the shop foreman. I've been working there for about 15 years. Maybe here's the cut lid and the drawings on it. You know what you do to it?
The only inch and a half I could find.
We fabricate schools, hospitals, libraries, small buildings. If I tell somebody no and I go to shake my head, the nose kind of wiggles around, which is kind of embarrassing.
Oh, okay. All right,
cool. All right. I always feel like people are staring at me. Sometimes people bring it up, sometimes they don't. But I know they're always staring at it, and I really feel uncomfortable about it. I know my nose probably scares people when they first come up to me, but if they could look past that, I got a good heart, and I'm a good person. And I think they would like to get to know me.
Hello.
Hello, how are you doing?
Very nice to meet you, sir. Thanks for coming all the way out here. Where'd you come from?
Louisiana.
Louisiana. Well, welcome. First of all, you look like one of the members of ZZ Top. So I guess you're seeing us for your nose.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you know what this is? You know what it's called? Rhinophyma, it looks like, from this distance. Rhinophyma is like a severe form of rosacea. You might have heard of rosacea before. Some people, especially men, they can get a thickening of their skin on the nose in particular. Does it cause you pain or does it cause any discomfort for you?
I have a hard time breathing. It's uncomfortable.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to take a look, okay?
Yeah. Whatever you need to do.
It involves quite a lot of your nose here, but it's really the front of your nose that you have the brunt of it. I just concern mainly because this is a pretty large area with a good blood supply to it, so that's what I think about.
Obviously, this is a big case of rhinophyma, and I don't want to promise the world that I can take all of this out in one get-go because there's risks. I know I have to take this off slowly and gradually. I mean, I never know what's under each layer here. I mean, who knows what you're gonna come across underneath there. And I'm gonna give it a try.
I can't promise everything, but let's see what we can do there.
Today, I'm using the surgical electrocautery loop. It cuts through tissue, but at the same time, it's going to help to seal little blood vessels there so you have less bleeding.
So she's gonna turn on this vacuum here. Make sure nothing ever hurts you. Cut that off.
Rhinophyma is really a thickening of oily skin. You get these enlarged pores that oil can store in, right? Oil and keratin, or dead skin cells. Interestingly, a lot of the size of his nose doesn't have so much to do with actual skin there. There are big pockets of butter in there. There's big pockets of oil in there. These are some of the biggest butter pockets I've ever seen.
Doing well. It's like it's so dense in there, it gets harder to cut. Okay, so now I'm looking at his nose.
I am getting a lot of moisture collecting on my electrocautery tool. And this is slowing me down because it's not getting hot enough to cut through the tissue. It's not as efficient as it usually is.
It feels better already.
It does? Oh, good. I like that. It feels better. You feel like lighter, maybe.
I can feel a little bit of pain, but I want her to keep going because I wanted her to finish it up.
Come on. Blood vessel there. We might get some more of those as we get closer down to the bottom here.
Stopping to cauterize these oozing blood vessels is certainly slowing me down, and that is something that I'm also considering because taking longer here will mean that the numbing will wear off.
That one right here. Oh, sorry. I'm sorry.
Damn it. The deeper I get, the larger pockets of oil I find.
Sometimes I think if I squeeze out more of it, maybe it'll get smaller and then I won't have to do as much.
And the bigger the blood vessels.
We're gonna have one little baby oozer there. That's what I wanted to get us.
I feel like I'm on this rhinophyma battlefield. It's like I'm hitting all these landmines of pocket butter, and I'm getting these blood vessels that wanna ooze. And we have Terry who's feeling some discomfort here. So now my goal is really focused on finishing the right side of his nose as much as I can. You know, I'm going to just trudge on through and get to the end, though. I've got to get to the flag. I got to capture it.
Look at that. It's like a little treasure here, in a way. I mean, not sure how to get this down completely. Sorry. Oh, sorry. Let me put some numbing right there. Hold on. I'm sorry, make him cry. This is hurting you, huh? A little bit? Or a lot more? When you say a little, I know it means a lot.
It's not bad.
Oh, it is. Yes, it is. This little thing here. And I'm just trying to squeeze out as much of this, of the extra little stuff you got in here, because I think that's gonna lead to it being smaller too in itself.
Yeah.
Terry is such a trooper. He really sat there so patiently as we took a good amount of time, really, to remove the larger portion of rhinophyma on his nose. I think that it's unsafe for me to fully proceed here because we're really reaching the limit of a safe level of numbing that he can really receive within a 24-hour period. So I would really like to see how he heals and to come back another day and to remove the rest of it. At least now, this should improve his breathing tremendously.
You are definitely a two-timer, but we're getting it. I've definitely made a difference here, for sure.
Yeah, it's a lot better.
Yeah, a lot better.
Unbelievable.
Right, it looks good on that side.
I feel happier about myself when I look in the mirror now. Big difference, big improvement. Can surely breathe better already.
I'd love to see you like in about a month, because it's gonna take a couple weeks for it to heal.
Feel great. I can breathe better already. I was wanting it all to get done in one day, but whatever it takes, thank you much.
It's not goodbye forever, but it's goodbye for now.
Okay, great.
Looking good.
I hope when I come back, she's happy with how it turned out. And finish the other side and make it look just as good as this one.